You know, while growing up, I had the most amazing relationship with my grandmother, and that's because she told beautiful stories about real people, beautiful stories that almost never had a happy ending, but a ray of light. Today, so many years later, in my role as the SMB leader for India, I am so proud to put together a series called SMB Stories Matter that bring together a set of very curated stories of resilience from different parts of the country, of businesses that have survived despite the pandemic, of businesses that have innovated during the pandemic, and of businesses that have managed to hold on to their customers, despite most of India practically coming to a standstill over the last 3 months. I am profiling a very young entrepreneur today. Her name is Vartika Punjabi. Vartika runs this store called Ada in Lucknow, bang in the center of the city, which is called Hazrat Ganj. And Vartika is going to talk to us about how they've used the Facebook family of apps, especially Instagram, in order to make sure that they don't lose their customer base during these times, in order to make sure that they continue to engage with customers during these times, and also show them some of their best collections. Vartika, thank you so much for your time, and thank you so much for coming here today. So Vartika, you know, I've seen this amazing video in 2015, which was really the video that was called The Making of Chicken Curry. It's the most amazing video that we saw. We know that it viraled hugely. Tell me a little more, and if it had anything to do with the inspiration of running Ada today.
As the video title suggests, the making of chicken curry. We've encapsulated all processes that a fabric goes through to create a glamorous final product. So you might see, you know, a lehenga, you know, a fancy lehenga or a very classic simple angarkha or a kurti, but you might not understand what goes behind making it. So that's what the video speaks about, you know, from sourcing a fabric and cutting it into a silhouette, from the chapai, which is basically a wooden block, which has a carved design on it, which is, you know, sort of chapoed on the kapda with neel. So, you know, getting that done, then the women artisans are basically, you know, they take clothes in bundles, then they embroider it from the comfort of their homes. They bring it back to the, you know, the washing guy. He sort of hand washes the entire thing multiple times to get rid of all that blocking. And after that, you know, the finishing touches to the fabric are provided. Then it is ready to be shelved. So, you know, for a person who doesn't understand or doesn't have the in-depth knowledge of the entire craft, for them to understand what product they're actually purchasing and what is the story behind that product, it is very difficult to justify the importance of the craft or the price of the craft, etc. So, yeah, that's how we got the idea of bridging that gap of educating the consumer, of spreading awareness about the craft, or, you know, sort of just piecing it all together. That's how we got the idea of the video, and, you know, we received an overwhelming response on that. We got million views, we got thousands of comments and shares. I think that has been a very valued, you know, video asset, social media asset, whatever you would call it, for our brand, and we're extremely, extremely proud of it.
I think, Vartika, you've done some of the most awesome work on IGTV. I know you run servicing via WhatsApp. Tell us a little more about it. Tell us what customers can do, what they can learn from you.
So I would say that Facebook, Instagram, ad managers, catalog managers, WhatsApp, they've all created a specific niche for them. Even though they all belong to the same Facebook family, I would say all of them serve a different and unique purpose to themselves. I would say Facebook has been very helpful for us in discovering audiences, in being able to find new people, explore untapped markets. Instagram has been extremely helpful in showcasing our collection. So, you know, all the IGTVs and creating stories of our new collections every now and then has really helped us in garnering a good community of loyal shopping enthusiast.
You know, you've seen a practical switch over of what was called footfalls, you know, in times when the pandemic wasn't there. And that switch of footfalls has literally happened from offline to online. Give me a little bit more of the flavor of this, right? What do you mean by footfalls have moved online? Is it because it's global markets? Is it because, you know, you have windows where you can, you know, showcase your products? Are you custom servicing? What are you doing here?
So, you know, the pandemic has sort of pushed us towards digitalization. So even though there were lots of traditional businesses who were eventually moving towards digitalization, this was more like a necessary jumpstart where you have to get on the bandwagon unless you just want to shut shop. So that's what the pandemic has essentially done for digital communities. And but obviously, having said that, having the Facebook group, you know, on our side has been extremely helpful. You know, applications such as Instagram, Facebook, and having tools like Ad Manager, Catalog Manager, Audiences, all of that has just made reaching your consumer easier.
We had recently released the Turn the Tide report, which basically spoke of how, you know, the demand for apparel is rising, how more customers are coming online, how they're more willing to spend more online than they were previously. Make me a bridge to say what would change, and you already have this amazing inspirational journey, but what would you do differently even now to make sure that you're really on top of your game and the pandemic isn't hurting you as much?
So our twin flagship stores are situated in the middle of Hazratganj, which is the main market street. And in spite of that, we have seen a drastic fall in the footfall of, you know, tourists, of even normal residents of the city to come out for, you know, things like shopping. This month, we're launching a new concept called virtual shopping. So not only are we, you know, going to have our products going live on our website and, you know, advertisements going out on Facebook or Instagram, we are actually trying to create a virtual shopping experience wherein a customer who is unable to reach our like physical store at our flagship stores can actually get the entire experience at the screen. So, you know, it's going to be something on the lines of getting a live, a Facebook live, an Instagram live, all of these things coming together in small bits and pieces to recreate the entire shopping experience on your phone screen. So, you know, having the store go live, having, you know, the entire, having all your brand elements, essentially having your customer support, having your, you know, brand elements, I would say, you know, the entire the music, the touch, the feel, everything, trying to encapsulate all of that on a digital platform on the screen of the consumer is what I think is going to be what the future of Ada looks like.
That is so good to know, Vartika. And thank you so much for spending time with me today. Truly, truly motivated by your journey. And I'm sure a lot of other people who are watching this would love to know a lot more about how you've been engaging with the Facebook family of apps. But more importantly, I'm really, really looking forward to coming to Lucknow and to your store when the pandemic allows us to travel. Thank you so much for investing in the Facebook family of apps. Thank you so much for your time.